Hello sa lahat. Ako si Lindie, taga South Africa at Singapore. Hindi ko alam. Natututo ako ng Tagalog ngayon, but it's a bit difficult to explain my situation with Tagalog right now. So, this video is going to be a little complicated. It's about me learning Tagalog, but also maybe taking a little break. Let's get into it. At the beginning of the year, I had really high goals and expectations that I would learn Tagalog. I've been using this book, Easy Tagalog, and I mapped out how many chapters I would need to do throughout the year, but I never really got to it. And this video is more to share about why and how things change, and whether or not I will be continuing with learning Tagalog. I had Filipino friends at school when I lived in Dubai back in 2005, 6, 7, 8. It's so hot, sorry. I feel like Tagalog is always gonna be there, but it just doesn't seem to make its way to being a priority language for me at the time of my life. So for now, you know, I'm living in Singapore. It's a lot more important for me to learn Mandarin Chinese. I've been upping my Spanish. Unfortunately, Tagalog is taking a little bit of a back burner, and I just want to be honest with you guys because I know that there is a lot of you who are really interested in my Tagalog learning journey. But with that being said, I will take you through the two notebooks I have filled up for Tagalog and how I've been learning Tagalog so far. I did take italki lessons for about 2 months, 2 or 3 months, with teacher Regina. If you want the link to her profile, I can definitely recommend her. She's incredible. But I'm not taking lessons anymore. So that was majority of where I got my learning from. And most of the things you'll see in my notebook here are from italki lessons. The very first things I learned at my first Tagalog lesson, which was actually about 2 years ago, I took a trial lesson, was just the basics like how to introduce yourself and say hello. It was super basics. It was like, kumusta ka? Mabuti naman? Hindi ako okay? It was just a lot of like beginner basic phrases, learning like oo versus opo, the beginner stuff in Tagalog. And then when I started taking more lessons near the end of last year, it was a lot more grammar, vocabulary, saying opposites, and so forth. A few months ago, I was going to make a video about how I'm learning Tagalog. I never got around to editing it, but I'll put the piece in here where I talk about the apps I'm using. If you're interested in learning Tagalog, maybe some of these apps can be good for you. I have a folder right here of all the apps that I'm currently using for Tagalog. The two apps that I'm using the most are Ling for Tagalog, and another one is called Vocally. And I'm also using Drop sometimes for some basic vocabulary. The other app I like to use is Closemaster. Sometimes the sentences are a bit formal, but it's still helping me pick up vocabulary. And other things I'm doing is watching a lot of Filipino movies on Netflix. So if you're interested for the next part, do stick around. I will transition into a flipthrough of my Tagalog notes. Quite hard to find really good textbooks. There is one from, I think it's Tuttle. This is also from Tuttle, but there's another one called Basic Tagalog. It's quite a big book and it's really boring. So I got this one, which is nice and compact. There's some cartoons. I don't know if I could flip to a cartoon. Ah, right over here. And it goes through different situations. But what I found about this book is that it goes quite quickly or quite fast. Maybe it's because I'm still a beginner in the language, but I felt that the jump from like chapter 1 to chapter 4 is quite high, which makes me think that if you are using this book for learning, you should use a lot of other sources, other apps, maybe take lessons, make sure you're watching a lot of Filipino content. I managed to get about 4 or 5 chapters in, which is not a lot, but I think I will be keeping this book. I don't just want to give up completely. So to answer the question, will I be continuing with my Tagalog studies? I'm not sure. And I really want to be honest with you all on this channel. I really don't know. Maybe. Never say never, but right now it's just not a priority. And I thought I owed it to you guys who have been really interested in my Tagalog learning journey that, you know, it's not something I'm saying goodbye to completely, but it's not something that I will be focusing all of my efforts on right now. Like I said, I will be keeping my books, so we'll see what happens. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you in the next video. Maraming salamat sa lahat sa panonood, and I will see you all in the next video. Sana all may good luck with language learning.